Toyota Camry is not just a product, it's a brand in itself. The Camry sells not because it's a Toyota, the Camry sells because it's the Camry. It's a success worldwide, they sell millions of units, and the competitors of Toyota would kill to have a sub-brand like this. It's a product that it sells purely because for what it is. And as this latest generation Camry Hybrid, it's only available in a hybrid form now in India, makes its debut into India, we're driving it today to see what it offers in a segment that's very small, you know. Selling a car for over 40 lakh rupees in India, which is not a fancy luxury German brand, is not easy. But it's got its pluses. And we're going to test it today to see how it fares. What? Latest generation of the Camry is based on Toyota's new TNGA platform. It's a platform it shares with the Lexus ES 300, which I've reviewed earlier. But of course, there are massive style differences. What strikes you first is this huge grey grille. You know, it does catch your eye, but I'm not a big fan. The whole plastic thing looks a little tacky. I think it could have been done a little better. But what I do think is the car overall in design is quite balanced. It's got proportions correct, it's slightly lower than the earlier car, it's slightly wider, it looks very well settled. I love the big 18-inch wheels, the machine finish works very well. And along the sides, you can see it has some very strong shoulder lines running along it. What's interesting, one of the highlights for me is the treatment behind the C-pillar. You can always see this indent. This quarter panel has a really deep indent, which is rare to find because it's mechanically or engineering-wise very difficult to produce, but I think Toyota's done a great job. For me, however, the highlight of the design has to be the rear end. It's a very, how should I say it, and I say it as a compliment, very Maserati-esque. Those big tail lights, wrap around tail lights, that chrome. And from the rear, it's actually really difficult to say it's a Toyota. And I mean it in the most positive manner. I think that, for me, is the most attractive part of the car. In the current scenario that we have in India, air pollution is going through the roof. It's a constant problem, especially more so in metropolitan cities. So there was an interesting conversation we had at dinner last night with Toyota India officials and a visiting scientist that they'd called to give us a talk about the benefits of electric cars versus hybrid cars versus internal combustion engines. And, you know, the fact is, and the scientist sort of gave us a presentation that emphasizes the fact that it sounds very nice, very techy, very futuristic to talk about getting electric cars and popularizing them in India. But for an electric car to be as practical, to have as much range as a normal internal combustion engine powered car that you buy today, the cost is incredible. You're looking at the same size of the car, if everything else remains the same. You're looking at anywhere between 50% to 100% cost increase. So the small hatchback you buy for 4 lakh rupees could easily be 6, 8, 10 lakh rupees. Problem is, all said and done, in India, we're still a poor country. We've developed a lot, we're still developing, but we don't have the kind of pockets, the kind of per capita income that allows us to actually buy proper electric cars. And in that case, hybrids seem to be the best choice. And I kind of agree with this. You see, hybrids offer you the practicality of an internal combustion engine car. You can fill them up like you fill up petrol or diesel. They give you an increased amount of range compared to traditional internal combustion engine car, because the efficiency levels in a strong hybrid like the Toyota Camry Hybrid go up substantially. I mean, I'm driving the Camry, I'm not the most efficient driver in the world. I do have a very heavy right foot, but it's still giving me between 15 and 17 kilometers per liter. And you have to remember, this is a proper sedan. This is a sedan which in size is as big as the Mercedes E-Class. So that actually tells you how competent hybrids are, that you can use them as you would use an internal combustion engine car. They're incredibly more efficient, which means you use less petrol, which means you pollute less. Also, they're less polluting than a traditional internal combustion engine car. And at the same time, because you're using less fuel, you're importing less fuel. So actually, your country's economy benefits. The Camry Hybrid is, I think, with the new, it's based on the new TNGA architecture that it shares with its Lexus ES sibling. It also shares the same 2.5-liter Atkinson cycle engine with a battery below the rear seat and an electric motor. Power output quite decent, 215 odd horsepower, lots of torque, and even though it's powered by an eCVT, I don't like CVTs in general, it's the instant torque that you get from the electric motor that actually really masks the effect in everyday driving. You know, you press the throttle, there's literally no waiting and you fly because there's so much torque in the engine. The other two, three things that are very sort of impressive about the car, the ride's fantastic. It has wishbone suspension at the rear, McPherson struts at the front, but the ride quality, dealing with bumps, dealing with bad roads, fantastically done. The seats are incredibly comfortable. You get a lot of space. 5 full-size adults, no problem. Tall adults, no problem. You get a lot of features. You get 9 airbags. You get a lovely JBL sound system that works quite well. You get a touch screen, a sunroof, 18-inch alloys. Really good-looking alloys, by the way. And I quite like the design language. Like I said earlier, other than the front grille, I think it's a really good-looking car. It stands out for all the right reasons. A couple of issues that exist for me. One, I think it's sort of a double-edged sword. The car's so refined, and like the ES, there's so much isolation from the outside that you tend to hear a lot more of the road noise coming from the tires. I told the Toyota engineers that, and they said, you know, the road noise is not amplified. It's not that the tires are making a lot more noise than they do normally. It's just that because everything else is so much more quietened down, you tend to hear that more. That's a logical explanation. Secondly, I think touchscreen, the audio system is still a little, it's a feel that Toyota still needs to catch up on. It's not that intuitive, it's slightly tricky to set up, and I think that's where they can catch up. But at 37 lakhs ex-showroom, this is one of the most environmentally friendly cars you can buy in India, and that's one of the trump cards of the car, other than the fact of the space and the comfort. And in general, because it's a Toyota, you expect it to run for decades, you expect it to outlive you. The service experience of Toyota is phenomenal. There's great resale. The only actually tricky part about the car, which will sort of be the only hindrance for it, is that it competes in a segment at a price point where people can also afford the German trio or the Volvos, you know, the Audis, the Mercedes, BMWs and Volvos. And that's the only thing that holds against the Camry. That is the brand good enough at that luxury segment? The product, it's phenomenal. I don't have a doubt of the product. It's not an enthusiast car, but it's never positioned to be. It's a car that you drive, that you're comfortable in, that'll take you anywhere and have no issues. But the brand is probably the only issue. At 40 odd lakhs on road, you would have to be somebody who cares really well for the environment and gets Japanese reliability added to it. So that's the only thing that I can fault it. That the brand at 40 odd lakhs, that's the only thing that might drive people to buy something else. Other than that, the Camry, it's phenomenal. It's an engineering tribute, and I'm quite fond of it.